So hello all, in this video we are going to discuss about arithmetic mean AM. So in the previous video we have completed till question number 13 of exercise 9.2. So in this video we will discuss AM. So what is AM? AM is, if suppose there are two numbers A and B. So if we have to represent any number A in between these two numbers such that the number should be in arithmetic progression, right? So if we can insert a number a between them so that a comma b is an AP, right? Such a number a is called arithmetic mean of the numbers a and b. So here in this case a will be equal to a plus b upon 2, right? A will be equal to a plus b upon 2. That is called arithmetic mean, right? So if suppose n numbers are there in between, so we can call them a1, a2. So a1, a2, a3 up to an, right? B. So a1 value will be equal to, okay, so d will be equal to, because we know that b is which number of term? First, second, third, fourth. This is n plus 1 and this is n plus 2. So b is n plus 2 number of terms. So from there we will get d is equal to b minus 1, b minus a upon n plus 1. So this is how we are going to do with the help of questions. So it's just waste of time if we are going to discuss formulas. Simple meaning you should know what is AM, right? So let's start with question number 13, sorry, 14th. 13th we have already done. So in question number 14th we have, insert 5 numbers between 8 and 26 such that the resulting sequence is an AP. So 8 and 26 we have to represent, we have to find out 5 numbers. So A1, A2, A3, A4, A5, right? So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7th. So A7 is 26. So this implies a plus 6d is 26 and a value is 8 here. So 8 plus 6d is 26. So this implies 6d is equal to 26 minus 8. So 26 minus 8 is 18. So d is equal to 18 upon 6. D is equal to 3, right? So d is 3. So a1 will be equal to a plus d. So 8 plus 3. 11. A2 will be equal to a plus 2d. 8 plus 2 bracket 3, 8 plus 6, that is 14, right? A3 will be a plus 3d. 8 plus 3 bracket 3, 9 plus 8, 17. A4 will be equal to a plus 4d. 8 plus 4 bracket 3, 12 plus 8, 20. A5 will be equal to a plus 5d. 8 plus 5 bracket 3, 15 plus 8 is 23, and sixth term is this 26. So these are the values. This is question number 14. Let's move on to next question. Question number 15. If a is the AM between a and b, right? So a is equal to an plus bn upon an minus 1 plus b n minus 1, then find the value of n. So in the next question we have to find out the value of n. So we know that if a and b are forms an AP, so a value will be equal to a plus b upon 2, which is equal to an plus bn upon an minus 1 plus bn minus 1, right? So let's just cross multiply this. So a plus b a n minus 1 plus b n minus 1 is equal to 2 bracket a n plus b n, right? So let's open it. So this is a multiplied by a n minus 1 is a n plus a b raised to the power n minus 1 plus b raised to the power b a n minus 1 plus this is what, bn is equal to 2 an plus bn, right? So इफ आई टेक दिस ए एन एंड बी एन देयर, सो हेयर वी हैव टू ए एन एंड टू बी एन, सो ए बी रेज टू द पावर एन माइनस वन प्लस ए एन माइनस वन बी इज इक्वल टू ए एन प्लस बी एन, राइट? सो वॉट वी कैन डू इन दिस, लेट्स टेक, लेट्स सेपरेट द साइड्स, सो वी हैव a n माइनस 1 b इज इक्वल टू बी एन माइनस ए बी एन माइनस 1, राइट? सो वी कैन टेक a n माइनस 1 कॉमन, सो हेयर वी हैव a माइनस b, वी कैन टेक b n माइनस 1 कॉमन, सो हेयर वी हैव b माइनस a, राइट? सो वी कैन से इफ आई टेक माइनस साइन कॉमन, सो ए एन माइनस वन ए माइनस बी माइनस बी एन माइनस वन ए माइनस बी, वी हैव टेकन माइनस साइन कॉमन, सो दिस फ्रॉम दिस विल गेट कैंसल्ड, सो वी कैन से दिस इज होल्ड ऑन समवेयर आई थिंक वी हैव मिस्टेकन, सो दैट इज ए एन माइनस ए एन माइनस वन बी, दिस इज पी एन, ओके दिस विल बी माइनस बी एन, सो दिस विल बी ऑटोमेटिकली बी एन माइनस वन इफ आई टेक कॉमन, सो दिस विल बी ए माइनस बी, राइट? दिस फ्रॉम दिस विल गेट कैंसल्ड, सो वॉट डू वी हैव ए एन माइनस वन इज इक्वल टू बी एन माइनस वन, राइट? सो वी कैन से दिस इज a n minus 1 is equal to b n minus 1, so this implies a n minus 1 upon b n minus 1 is equal to 1, so a upon b raised to the power n minus 1 is equal to 1, okay, we can say this 1 can be written as a upon b raised to the power 0, any number raised to the power 0 is 1, so we can say n minus 1 is equal to 0, so this implies n is equal to 1, so this is our answer, so n is equal to 1. Right. Next question number 16th. So in 16th question we have between 1 and 31 m numbers have been inserted. So 1, a1, comma a2, a3, comma am and a, this is 31. 1 and 31 m numbers have been inserted. So that the resulting sequence is an AP and the ratio of 7th and m minus 1th term is 5 upon 9. A 7 upon A m minus 1 is equal to 5 upon 9. So this is given, right? Okay. So we know that total A is 1, B is 31 and n is equal to m plus 2, right? 1, 2, 3, this will be n plus 1. And this will be n plus 2, right? So n is equal to m plus 2, right? So let's solve. So we know that 31 is am plus 2 is equal to 31, right? So this can be written as am plus 2 is a plus m plus 2 minus 1 d. So 31 is equal to a is 1 plus m plus 1 d. So 30 is equal to m plus 1 d. This implies d is equal to 30 upon m plus 1, right? So d is equal to 30 upon m plus 1. Now if d is 30 upon m plus 1, we know that the ratio is this one. So a 7 is a plus 6 d upon a plus m minus 1th term, right? Ratio of m minus 1th term. So this will be m minus 1 d, a plus, sorry, just hold on. This will be m minus 1th term. Okay, a m minus 1. Okay, let's find out first. So d is this. So a1 will be equal to a plus d. A2 will be equal to a plus 2d. A1 is a plus d, a plus 2d. A3 will be equal to a plus 3d. Similarly, am minus 1 will be equal to a plus m minus 1 d, right? So the ratio of 7th and m minus 1th term, so a7 is a plus 7d, 7th term, so a7, so a7 will be here a plus 7d, so a plus 7d upon a plus m minus 1 d is equal to ratio is given 5 upon 9, right? So let's put the value of d in this. So a plus 7 bracket d is 30 upon m plus 1 upon a plus m minus 1, 30 upon m plus 1 is equal to 5 upon 9, right? So taking LCM m plus 1 and cancelling it from numerator and denominator, we'll have a bracket m plus 1 plus 7 bracket 30 upon a bracket m plus 1 plus m minus 1 bracket 30 is equal to 5 upon 9. So this is what a value is 1, so m plus 1 plus 73210 upon m plus 1 plus 30m minus 30 is equal to 5 upon 9. Cross multiply, so 9m plus this will be 211. 9 multiply 1 is 9, 9 multiply 1 is 9, 9 2 is 18, 1899 is equal to 30m plus m is 31m. 31 multiply 5, 5 1, 5 3 15, 155m. Minus 29, so minus 29 multiply 5, 145. Right, so let's separate out. So 155 m minus 9 m is equal to 1899 plus 145, so this will be equal to for 9 and 5 4 and again 9 and 5 4 and 8 and 1 9 and 1944, so this will be 146 m is equal to 1944, so m is equal to 1944 upon 146, right? So just cancel out these values. 1944, sorry, this is 2044 divided by 146, so this will be equal to 14, so m is 14, right? This is question number 16, right? In this way we have solved this question. Next is question number 17. So a man starts repaying a loan. As first installment of rupees 100, if he increases the amount by rupees 5 every month, so 105, 110 and so on, what amount he has to pay in the 30th installment? So 30th installment, right? So you have to find out A30, right? So simply A30 you have to determine, right? So just find out A30, it will be equal to A plus 30 minus 1d. Very easy question, you can easily do it, right? So simple, just put the values and get the answer. Next is question number 18. The difference between any two consecutive interior angles of a polygon is 5 degrees. If the smallest angle is 120 degrees, find the number of sides of the polygon. Now if the first angle is 120, smallest angle is 120, so a is 120 degrees, and 5 degrees, d is 5 degrees, right? 5 degree difference. So find the number of sides of the polygon, right? So number of sides, let it be n. Now we know that sum of all angles of a polygon with side n is 180 degrees, multiply by n minus 2. Sum of all angles of a polygon, 180 bracket n minus 2, right? So that is Sn is equal to 180 bracket n minus 2. So Sn formula is n by 2, 2a plus n minus 1 d is equal to 180 bracket n minus 2. So n bracket 2 bracket 120 plus n minus 1 5 is equal to 360 bracket n minus 2. Just open the brackets and solve the value for n. So soon you will get n is equal to, just simplify the value, soon you will get n is equal to either 9 or 16, right? So n value will be either 9 or 16. So just solve this expression. So this is all about exercise 9.2. In the next video we will discuss exercise 9.3, GP, geometric progression, which is new for you people, and GM, geometric mean, right? So just be in touch, and thank you for watching the video.